Okay, looks like that's it for the friendly arm in.
Such menial tasks.
Best to get some rest.
My inn is open to all who behave themselves. It's been dreadful slow business lately.
Ilminster's choice beer. Maybe we'll get some rumors if we get some Aluriath wine. I heard there's some sort of trouble in Nashkel. Something sinister has been moving about in the Nashkel mines. Nobody seems to know for sure. Too busy coping with the bandit raids and such. Something sinister, And take that too. Now, I'm not sure the mechanics of this, so let me just... Bentley, the owner of the Friendly Arm Inn, told us that the iron trade has slowed greatly over the past few weeks. There are rumors of something disrupting operations in the Nashkel mines, contributing to the iron shortage.
My inn is open to all who behave themselves.
Noble accommodations, I guess, would be good enough. None but the most pampered dandy would have complaints with these accommodations. Now, if I rent it, I will automatically sleep. So let me try to scribe this scroll first. Armor. By means of this spell, this wizard creates a magical field of force that serves as if it were a scale mail armor, armor class 6. It is cumulative with dexterity, and in the case of fighter mages, with the shield bonus. The armor spell does not hinder movement, adds no weight or encumbrance, and does not prevent spellcasting. It lasts until successfully dispelled or until the duration runs out. Armor class 6. So what armor class are we? 7. Not that much of a... But I suppose every bit helps, right? And soon we won't be using that scroll, that spell at all, rather. Right magic. Copy to the spellbook. Sweet! Now,
what is it?
Quick item. All right, I wanted to try to, you know, I'm going to save that for next episode. Talk to Jaheira and what? Jaheira and Khalid. I can't believe I get them messed up so much. How do I get to my spellbook? Here. Okay, this is memorized. So we got sleep. Oh, we need that. Unfortunately, one out of one, I cannot memorize anymore. How sad.
Uh-huh.
Oh, Jaheira speaks. Has Gryan ever showed you much of the forest and taught you about nature? Feel free to ask me any questions you have about them, anytime you wish. Actually, when the party is going through the forest, I would rather you ask me for advice or let me lead. What is the most reliable and nutritious forest fare to be had if I run out of provisions? Grubs, no question. and roasted. They're tasty. Think of nuts with a creamy center. Oh, it's been a while. I think we're gonna just keep going. Split this in two, supposedly. With a creamy center. Well, since she has stuff, she started talking to me.
Stand back and watch this.
Wait.
I need some help.
What?
I want to talk to...
Fine.
There I am, okay. Jaheira fell behind the party for a moment, examining a peculiar plant. Inside the inn? I suppose they might have some potted plants around here. She ends up putting it into her medicinal bag, and now she's about to catch up with the rest of the group. Perhaps it would be wise to take advantage of the situation and trade a couple words in private. Oh my, quite a lot of it. Got a bit here. You ask her lots of personal questions. Talk about Jaheira's problems and hopes in a friendly and kind manner, in hopes of making Jaheira confide in you. What would you like to know, Sapphire? A few things about my past? I was born in Tethir and carried away from my family castle by a servant girl, while the rest of my family perished in the recent civil war. She brought me to a grove of druids who reared me. There I learned to protect the forest and all its inhabitants. I met Gorion and Khalid long after that. And that will have to do in satiating your curiosity, Sapphire. So, Jaheira, can you tell me more about yourself? I am sorry, but I see that someone else is in need of my attentions. So what is your opinion of my leadership, Jaheira? Keep quiet, O omnipresent authority figure, and let me heal you. I will let you know that a bleeding leader rarely inspires the morale of the group.
Please, seat yourselves whatever you wish.
Why are you always scowling so much? Because even though you were seriously wounded, you still managed to find time to ask stupid questions. Now hold still and let me heal you. Yeah, because we're damaged. Alright, let's talk to Khalid. You find a moment with Khalid, away from everyone else. Perhaps it'd be wise to take advantage of the situation and ask a few personal questions. Khalid usually is too shy to talk of himself in public. You are used to hearing things from the bottom of people's hearts, so you try to charm Khalid into telling you more about himself. I would rather tell you something about Gorion, but that may upset you. More friendly and kind manner about... confide in me? Well, I was a bastard child, born to an elven concubine. She died soon after, and my father, he cared for only for his legitimate children. The little attention I received from him was usually violent. I joined the army and left home. Then, well, it came to pass that I became a harper, and when captured by some evildoers, I was narrowly saved by Gorion and Jaheira. I was tortured, and Jaheira, she nurtured me back to health. I fell in love with her then, but she would not agree to marry me, because she thought that I was mistaking gratitude for love. He smiles. I persisted, however. There isn't much more to say, really. Perhaps I could tell you a story of Gorion one day, but for now I suggest we continue on. So, Khalid, can you tell me more about yourself? Best not to tarry when there may be danger about. Well, I would say this place isn't too dangerous, but we did just get attacked right out on the steps. How do you think things are going? Jaheira? What were we discussing that we meant to tell Sapphire about? You wanted to go to the Nash Kel Mines, I know. I noticed you wince. Are you alright, Khalid? All this killing, will it ever end? We've killed so much, I know. So obviously, we're meant to talk about this stuff with them after we leave the inn. Alright, so I've memorized a spell. I can't use it, but we need to rest up. Oh, actually, what I wanted to do...
What is it this time?
I was interrupted by Jaheira, actually. Okay, so she's got everything memorized that she can do.
Yes, O omnipresent authority figure.
Priest scrolls. Okay, so she's got cure light wounds, two of them, and entangle. And we can't have any more. We can only swap out the ones we have. We have armor of faith. The caster of the Armor of Faith receives significant protection against melee and magical attacks. This magical armor is a force of energy that absorbs a portion of damage intended for the caster. At first level, the protection is 5%, and every 5 levels of the caster improves this by another 5%. For example, a 20th level priest would have 25% of her damage absorbed if protected by this spell. Good only for the caster. Entangle, a visual range, 15-foot radius. The caster is able to cause plants in the area of effect to entangle creatures within the area. The grasses, weed, bushes, and even trees wrap, twist, and entwine about the creatures, holding them fast. Once per round, a creature can attempt to save versus a spell with a +3 bonus to avoid entanglement. An entangled creature can still attack, but receives a -2 penalty to its armor class. And of course, Cure Light Wounds. Interesting, I wasn't aware that it was a necromancy spell. Oh, okay. 8 points of wound or other injury damage. Not 1d8. That's awesome. They made it a little better, because... I'm playing Eye of the Beholder 3 at the same time I play this game, and Cure Light Wounds will often just give you 1 point, because you're literally rolling a die, and you roll one, and that's as many points as you get back. So this is much better. It's a flat 8 points restored. So what else do we have? Detect evil. Discovers emanations of evil from any creature. Any evil creature within the range of the spell will glow red briefly. Bless. That's a great spell. By uttering the Bless spell, the caster raises the morale of friendly creatures by +1. Furthermore, it raises their attack and damage rolls by +1. The caster determines at what range the spell will be cast. At the instant the spell is completed, it affects all creatures in a 15-foot radius, centered on the point selected by the caster. Thus, affected creatures are leaving the area or still subject to the spell's effects. Those entering the area after the casting is completed or not. Makes sense. I'm kind of torn, but yeah, she doesn't... Once we get a fourth slot open here, we'll memorize Bless. Because Cure Light Wounds, yeah, I'm sure we'll need more than one casting of that. Probably more than two. Doom. This spell causes a feeling of doom to overwhelm the target. For the duration of the spell, the target receives a -2 penalty to all her rolls, including Thaco and saving throws. There is no saving throw for this spell. That looks very useful. So here's Entangle. Shillelagh, I think it's pronounced. The spell enables the caster to create a magical cudgel that has a +1 bonus to its attack roll and inflicts 2d4 points of damage on opponents. Doesn't last that long. So +1, 2d4. Better than what she has. 1d6. 2d4 is slightly better than 1d6. Because you can't do less than 2. And you can do up to 8. Alright, looks good. We can't memorize anything else. Let's rest.
As you direct.
It's been dreadful slow business lately.
Well, let us give you some business then. We'll take your noble accommodations. And we'll actually...
My inn is open to all who behave themselves.
We'll actually take your noble accommodations. And we're good, aren't we? Awesome. Now...
Yes? Such menial tasks.
I guess we'll head out. I'm not sure we're ready to take on those hobgoblins just yet.
Fine.
But I'm definitely amenable to messing around with some gibberlings. Stuff quite a bit unexplored here. But I think after we clear the area to the south, we'll be good.
Such menial tasks.
You know,
a simple matter.
There's an item around here, isn't there? Or is that in Candlekeep? Not sure. Never mind. Let's explore.
A simple matter.
What do we have? A wolf. Okay. At least one wolf.
yes? If none are better.
And Jaheira is pretty good as well.
You've a task as good as done.
Something up?
What is it?
Okay, quite a few wolves.
Can I help you?
Nature's servant awaits.
Hurry up!
What?
Ugh! We're already pretty messed up. We wanted gibberlings, not wolves. Weapon unusable. Did it break?
Yep.
Uh-huh.
Oh. I didn't successfully cast that, didn't I? Is that wolf dead? No, not yet. Okay, one down. So her weapon... because it's unusable. Doing fine, Khalid. Better than Jaheira was, that's for sure. So Imowen's missing. It doesn't say unusable anymore.
Yes.
I am attacking, right? Well done.
Fine. What is it? A simple matter? What? A simple matter?
Well, that was exciting.
You've a task?
Yes. Heal thyself. Much better. Okay. Might as well continue.
As you direct.
Yes, a simple matter.
Because we need experience, we need to level up. Been here. This area here is quite a big map. Big area. Let's see what other dangers await. Ooh, what's that? A ring. A magical ring. We know a wizard slayer can't use it, but otherwise we don't know anything about it until we identify it. Did I look at everything the lady in the temple was selling? Perhaps she, Ugh.
What is it?
Ah, she's been forgotten. Left behind. Good thing we might have had need of your services. Right now you can carry my crap for me. I wonder if this can go in the scroll thing. It can. Sweet. So I can put my letters in here. This gives us some more precious inventory space. Awesome. We also have that wand to identify as well. Guess he didn't want to buy that quarterstaff. Everything organized here. That's good. So, stuff to be memorized. We've already memorized the belt. Not memorized, identified, sorry. And now that we've sorted that out, where do we have to go next? Might as well explore out. One of the things I love about this game is clearing out the fog of war. So that ring might have been the thing I was looking for, though I thought it was in a tree. But possibly that's another item. What do we see? Gibberlings! Gibberlings, rather. Of course, these two are lagging behind. Did you hear it? Well, Khalid's up here.
yes?
Attack! Where are you two
Good to
going?
Go. You can count on me.
What? A simple matter.
You. My turn to save the day.
No, your turn to run away.
Yes.
Makes a nice rhyme, though. Alright, so she's already used up her magic missile. And she's used hers. And this is not a target, so so there's three of them.
Nature for the group.
Something else?
What is it?
I think we're all attacking this one. I hope so. You're fine. One down. Hopefully they have some loot for us. That might be loot or it's dead body, I'm not sure.
Yes, oh omnipresent authority
what?
Figure.
She needs a ranged weapon.
What is it this time?
As well as Nira.
You have need of me?
Hurry up! You can count on me.
Oh, I can't.
Yep.
Yes?
Yeah, I got a little reckless there with the last one.
Fine.
8 gold. Anything else nearby? Ooh. Another Sinstone gem. You can barely see that. And another.
What such menial tasks?
Okay, we're pretty much fine. Shall we continue with this little corner here? I like fighting the gibberlings. They're just the right amount of... well, I wouldn't say challenge, but they're good for this party. Until we level up a little bit more. Anything back here? No. Got a lot to explore here. Oh! What happened here?